from Ann Arbor, Michigan, Big Ten Women's Gymnastics here on BTN, and a championship qualifier quad meet between Iowa and Minnesota and Penn State and Michigan. A regular season championship to chase and a chance at a prime spot in next week's Big Ten Championships. Your NCAA rankings look like this. Six of the eight teams ranked in the top 25 in the country. You will get to see three of them in the top 15 here from Ann Arbor today. So happy to have you with us in what is a new adventure here for women's gymnastics here in the Big Ten Conference. All eight teams are competing here this afternoon in two different quad meets. The first here in Ann Arbor and the second in East Lansing. You'll see coverage of that once our broadcast has been complete. Now the stakes at hand. The top two finishers in each of these different quad meets will get a spot in the evening session in next week's Big Ten Championships. And it's important to mention that second note. The conference champion decided on the highest overall score next week, regardless if they do compete in the afternoon or the evening session. My partner here, our gymnastics analyst all season long on the Big Ten Network, a four-time Olympic medalist in Shawn Johnson. 2008 was the golden year for her on the balance beam, and she brought home the silver there for Team USA, has retired in 2012, and is now trying her hand in the broadcasting world. Happy to have you with us as always, and fun here today because so much to compete for these teams.
Definitely a lot of pressure on these guys' shoulders. They're trying to qualify to the evening session next weekend because that's where the crown for the Big Ten champion is normally given.
Well, we'll keep our eye on a couple of all-arounders too. Let's start with Minnesota sophomore Lindsay Mabel, who was last year's freshman of the year, and she's picked up where she left off.
Really leading the Gophers. She's been progressing all season, nationally ranked number 9 in the all-around. Her strongest events are vault and floor, so you want to stick around to see those two events for her.
And she will compete and go head-to-head against one of the other top all-arounders in Michigan's Joanna Sampson, a senior, and really wrapping up one of the best careers Michigan has ever seen.
Very experienced competitor. She's hit 35 out of 35 routines this season. She's nationally former champion on the floor, and she ends tonight with her floor routine, so make sure you stick around to see that.
Yeah, it'll be fun to watch here from start to finish. Our first rotation between these four teams coming up. Michigan to the vault, Minnesota to the bars, Penn State to the beam, and Iowa to the floor. All coming up next. Welcome back to the Chrysler Center and the championship qualifier quad meet. We finished warm-ups here between these four teams. We want to remind you that BTN goes where you want, when you want it, with BTN to go, presented by Auto Owners Insurance. Watch live events on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. To learn more, visit btntogo.com. Also available in the App Store and on Google Play. You can download it today. Your current Big Ten standings as we approach here the afternoon. Michigan 4-0 and could finish a perfect 7-0 with a victory here and finishing first in this quad meet here today against the other three teams. Your lineups, Michigan receives the normal Olympic order here today. That means Bev Plocky in her 25th season in the Wolverines will start on vault, go to bars, beam, and floor. That'll be their order. Here is their vault lineup, and keep an eye there on Austin Shepherd there on vault. I know you're excited to see her.
Very strong vaulter.
Minnesota, they're on the bars. Meg Stevenson in her fourth season as a coach, though she has been in Minneapolis much longer than that. She is now the only head coach, kind of shared that duties with her husband, Jim, for several years, and there is their bar lineup as well. We talked about Lindsay Mabel, a connection that you're looking forward to see there, Sean. And then, of course, Jeff Thompson in his fourth season at Penn State. There's the beam order. They get kind of the tough rotation here, starting on beam and then going to floor next in their second rotation. And Larissa Ruby, looking for her first Big Ten win here this season. They will start out on floor, which you could argue is probably their strongest event here as a team. She's got the 12 kids, she says, but 11 will compete here this afternoon, and of those 11, 6 walk-ons.
Starting on floor with them is a very good decision and a good draw because they have more team spirit and confidence on that event than all four.
They are fun and exciting to watch, and again, these teams get a certain amount of time here to warm up. We have about a minute and a half left here in these warm-up sessions. But again, to emphasize what is at stake here in this championship qualifier, quad meet. The top two teams, are there two quads going on? The one here in Ann Arbor and one later on here in East Lansing. Of course, that one will be broadcast after this one is complete. But here is what's at stake. The top two finishers between those eight teams will go to the evening session in next week's Big Ten Championships. It's important because, as we talked about at the beginning, you can win a conference championship next week if you compete in the afternoon session, but typically you just don't get the scores in the afternoon session that you do in the evening session, and thereby the importance of competing there at night. So we're about to get underway here. Again, an outright regular season Big Ten championship on the line here for the Michigan Wolverines, the only unbeaten team going into competition here this weekend. Also important to mention, too, Minnesota actually shared that regular season championship last year with the Michigan Wolverines. And this is their first visit to Ann Arbor since the 2011 NCAA Regional Championship. There you see the banners there, the Super Six. Michigan has not gotten there since 2011, led by a group of seniors. And when those folks were seniors, the seniors now on this year's team were freshmen. And they're trying to lead the way and get this team back to the Super Six and follow the example that they had when they were freshmen and those seniors got them there for the last time in 2011. So the warm-ups here are now done here in Ann Arbor and are set to begin. Now, all four events will be taking place at the same time. We'll try to bounce around and show you as many competitors and as many different routines as we can. It's interesting to talk to some of the coaches as they approach this. It's obviously a new setup here for the Big Ten Conference. Some of them will do some score watching and some scoreboard watching to see where they are and trying to get in that top two finish. Some don't even want to know.
Talking with a lot of the coaches, they say coming in here, they don't look at the scores, and it's all about just trying to hit, trying to stay as a team, and not even focusing on the results.
One of the all-arounders here for the Gophers is Jenny Covers. She's a junior. This will be her fourth time this season competing in the all-around competition. She is in the leadoff spot in the bar routine here for Minnesota. And just one of two all-arounders. Now, we talked about Lindsay Mabel. Here is the other all-arounder here for Minnesota.
Starting off on bars is never easy. It's a very pressure-filled event. Going straight into her first release move. Huge Jaeger, straight to a shoot over. Great connection there with good form. Leading the team off, just her dismount, one small step. Great way to start.
Now Michigan starting out on the ball, Talia Shirelli. Kicking things off there for Michigan. We'll update you on Jenny Cover's score, but we'll head over to the vault here and check out Shirelli. Leading off most of the year here for Michigan in this spot.
Going in for a Yurchenko layout full. Small little hop, probably 210 deduction. Again, a great start for Penn State.
She recorded a 9.75. That was happened just moments ago, and her score coming in as a 9.75 there on that vault. We'll head back to the bars. Kayla Schlechta, one of the seniors here for the Gophers, will see her most likely, unless things change, in three different events here this afternoon on bars, floor, and vault.
It's always important when you're one of the first to start on an event, you're really leading your team off, trying to get that momentum going. So the pressure is really on your shoulders.
Interesting for me to hear you say bars is one of the pressure-packed events. I would guess that beam is right up there, and maybe bars is second behind
that. I would say, yeah, definitely, beam and then bars. But it's one of those where you can fall off very easily or disconnect, and, you know, it loses your confidence a lot. Releasing here to Katja. A little low, but executed it nicely. Just her dismount left. Double back.
Stuck it.
Landing.
Kayla Schlechta, that's going to be a big score there for the Minnesota Gophers. Jenny covers her teammate to update you on her score, a 9.75 on the bars to lead off. Here's Rima Zachariah back on the ball.
Right hand spring, front pike calf. Pretty big hop there on the landing, but huge height, so hopefully that'll make up for it.
We will see Zachariah on the floor as well. She's been in that second spot there on the vault. Really three meets to make this the fourth here for Michigan. Again, all four events taking place at the same time, but here between Michigan, Minnesota, Penn State, and Iowa. We're gonna try to jump around to as many events as we can. Sachi Sugiyama, a junior here for Michigan, the 2012 Big Ten vault champion just a moment ago. Here's the junior on the vault for the Wolverines.
Another Yurchenko layout, 1.5 with one step forward. That vault is actually more difficult because it's a blind landing forward.
That happening moments ago, her score coming in as a 9.825 there for Sugiyama. We hop over to the floor. Ashley Edlin, one of the walk-ons there for Iowa. I mentioned that they have six who could be competing here this afternoon.
Something I love about Iowa's floor routines is they have so much fun. You'll see the teammates dancing on the sidelines. It's like a party, and they enjoy it, you can tell.
Guys looking to gain a little bit of momentum and hoping to do it here after this first rotation on what could be their best event here on floor.
Nice double pike. Great way to end a routine.
So Edlin, the freshman. Her coach Larissa Libby saying that sometimes she's hard on herself, holds back a little bit, didn't look like that there on that final pass. Back over to the ball, Natalie Bielstein here from Michigan, one of those seniors we had talked about trying to get back to the Super Six this year.
Yurchenko layout 1.5, again the blind landing, small step on the landing. Well done.
That vault happening just moments ago, and her score coming in as a 9.8. That's the highest, that and Sachi Sugiyama's scores, a 9.825 there on both. The two highest scores there for the Wolverines. Here's the one to watch, Lindsay Mabel, and you love this connection that she has in her routine.
I love it. She does a double Jaeger, which I honestly haven't even seen in elite gymnastics.
That says a lot.
Ginger, huge release. It's a routine that's jam-packed. Nice transition to the floor, and she'll go straight into her connection here. Ooh, full twisting double back. Looks as if she took her double connection out this meet.
Huh. Interesting. You were looking forward to seeing that.
I was.
Maybe playing it a little bit safe here for this weekend. We'll have to see maybe in next week's Big Ten Championships if she brings a full routine.
I would say probably. You know, they need that extra 10th, and they need some more difficulty, but greatly executed routine.
Now her teammate Kayla Schlechta, we saw her routine. She's coming through with a 9.775 on the bar routine in that second spot. Over to Joanna Sampson. Talked about her, the everything all around her, and the 2013 Big Ten Gymnast of the Year. Here she is on vault.
Yurchenko layout full. Great landing. A judge might be able to take a 10th for that, but you can also call that a stick, whatever the judge prefers.
They recorded it as a 9.825. Again, all the vaults that you're seeing are not happening live. We're going back to them. And this year, her score coming in is a 9.825, right behind Natalie Bielstein's 9.8. The championship qualifier quad meet, four teams competing here in Ann Arbor. Four teams will be competing later this afternoon in East Lansing, and a good turnout here. Michigan getting back-to-back home meets essentially last weekend, taking on Utah and UCLA last Friday, and recorded the second best score in Michigan history, a 197.825. They would love to get something like that again here this weekend. Going back to vault. This is the last vault, and Austin Shepherd is one to watch on this event.
Huge power going in. Your Chenko layout full. One small hop on the landing.
Kind of unusual for her. We don't see her take a hop there on the landing many times. She's normally been able to stick it. She has gotten a 9.975 three times on vault this year. Absolutely amazing.
About as close to a 10 as you can get.
Penn State on beam. We mentioned this is the toughest rotation to have in a quad meet, is to start out here on this event. Nicole Medvitz. Now, this will be her only event here this afternoon. Dealing with a shoulder injury. There she had a balance check.
Small bubble. Starting on beam is never easy. It's the most nerve-wracking event. If you fall off, your momentum is kind of thrown. Great flight series. That handspring layout.
You saw that she balanced herself there with just the one arm. It's because her right shoulder, that's the injury, and that's why they took her out of the bar lineup here today. Was able to do it with just the one arm.
Interesting. Normally you need two arms to do a very difficult pass, but if you're hurt, I guess one will work too. It does make it a lot more difficult, and judges get bonus for that. Beautiful artistry. Her flexibility is gorgeous to watch.
Nicole Medvitz, just a freshman. Emma Simpson and Medvitz, the two freshmen competing the most here for Penn State.
Front aerial, very solid. Coming up on just her dismount. One arm back handspring again to a layout full. I'd say the one arm's working for it.
Yeah, you know, very Jeff Thompson solid. Was a little bit worried about her dismount because of that shoulder injury, but it looked like she was able to perform it pretty good.
Very solid. She stuck her landing and her form was great, so she might want to keep the one arm. It gives her more difficulty.
Penn State recording some really high numbers here in this event. Crystal Welsh, the 9.725. Emma Simpson, 9.825. Randy Lau, a 9.8. And we will update you on Nicole Medvitz's score as well. We'll head back to the bars, though, from Minnesota.
Her coach just put her back up on the bars, so she must have fallen.
Picking this up in the middle of her routine, Sierra Thompson, one of the juniors, one of the all-around competitors here from Minnesota today.
Picking it back up very well. Just a dismount. Great extension double layout with a stuck landing.
Stuck the double layout. And tough as a competitor to get back up mentally, I would assume.
Very difficult. When your coach has to put you back up when it's disconnected, you kind of throw off your confidence. But she finished very well.
We'll head back to the beam. We just watched Nicole Medvitz, the freshman, wrap up her routine. Sydney Sanabria Robles, a redshirt junior, and a transfer from LSU competing here for Penn State. Now, Jeff Thompson said she had an injury at LSU. The doctors told her she would not compete in gymnastics ever again. She went to Penn State, transferred, became a walk-on, is now on scholarship, but obviously is competing well at an elite level here at the college level.
Great flight series, proving those doctors wrong. That handspring layout step out with huge height. Leap series, switch leap, straddle quarter. It's always more difficult to land on the beam sideways than it is front and back.
Why is that?
You just don't have as much room to work with. You know, you're looking at the mat instead of the beam. It throws off your balance a little bit. Sanabria
Robles has tied for the second highest score for her team this year on beam.
I can see that. Very solid competitor on beam. You can always tell a good competitor on beam because you'll see their balance checks in the air and they're able to fix it before they land. Just a dismount. Back handspring layout, 1.5 with a stuck landing. Coach looks pretty happy about that. I'd say that's a very high score.
She is following another very high score. We told you about the freshman Medvitz recording a 9.825 on beam just before her. And when you say it's going to be a high score on beam, that means something coming from a gold medalist on that event.
I'd say I might be able to judge a little bit, but I'd say I'd be a generous judge.
Angel Metcalf, her final pass here on the floor, one of the freshmen.
Layout, 1.5 punch layout. Not an easy pass to end with, but nails it.
And that is the end of her routine. Now, Angel Metcalf, she's going to be performing as an all-arounder here for Iowa. She had to deal with an early season shin injury. In fact, when you and I saw Iowa compete against Illinois, she only competed in the three events, but has gotten healthier and now has gotten and worked her way up to be one of the all-arounders. They will have three today here for the Hawkeyes. Cassidy Stouter getting some last-minute advice there from Rochelle Thompson, one of the assistants, and Jeff Thompson's wife. Does most of the coaching there on the beam event. Cassidy Stouter, a senior and another all-arounder. She has the team's best beam score this year.
Wow. Those last-minute pep talks always help. They
do
kind
they?
Of refocus you, get the distraction to go away, and remind you of what's going on. The beam is only 4 inches wide, so the
yes.
reminder that it is 4 inches wide always helps.
You see the 9.825 again. Nicole Medvitz recording that on the beam. Sanabria Robles with a 9.875 before Stouter.
First series, front aerial back layout step out. She took a little too long to connect it. So again, that's up to the judges whether or not they give her that bonus point or not.
So much subjectiveness going into this sport, obviously, with the judging. You could have almost a similar team in the first spot on beam versus the sixth spot, but typically the anchor gets the higher score.
Yeah, they always say you kind of weed out the bad scores, and that's why they always put the stronger ones at the end. You think you get the stronger scores towards the end.
Stouter used to be in leadoff here for Penn State. Madison Merriam, Sharia Musseritz, they were kind of the fifth and the sixth spot. And now Stouter maybe getting the benefit of being the anchor in some of the higher scores here this season.
Been a very strong routine. She had one small little bobble and a tiny little jump on the end, but solid routine.
Sydney Hare, just moments ago, finishing up on the floor, but we pick it up here at the end.
Punch layout full. Great landing, shows great control. And a lot of sass. Judges always enjoy watching that. They like to see the personality come out in the dance element.
As we have mentioned, a lot of pizzazz here for the Iowa Hawkeyes here on this event. Five times this year, to make it a sixth time if she can go through all four events that she has competed in the all-around. In particular, the last couple of weekends.
Going for our last pass. Punch layout 1.5. Very difficult to do. Finishes it a little short, but again, it'll be up to the judges how they judge that.
A 9.6 there coming in for Sydney Hare to wrap things up there on Iowa floor. So one rotation is down between these four teams. We have three more to go. Iowa to the vault, Michigan to the bars, Minnesota to the beam, Penn State to the floor. Don't miss any action on the Big Ten. Go to video.btn.com this week and check out the Big Ten Digital Network's upcoming schedule. Well, after the first rotation is complete, Penn State finishing off on beam a 49.225. And joining us now is head coach Jeff Thompson. And coach, that is your second best score all season long. Obviously a tough rotation for you guys to start on beam. How did you get your team prepared for that?
Yeah, I think a lot of coaches wouldn't want to start on beam. You know, it's a pressure-packed event, but it's been one of our great events throughout the year. So going over there, the kids knew we're just going to get up there. We're going to compete free, get up there and do what we know how to do. And they really looked relaxed up there, really proud of how they did. And a little surprised that we're in the lead, quite honestly.
And, coach, going into floor, it's a little less pressure-filled than beam. What can we look forward to seeing?
Well, now that we got that behind us, you know, the pressure is off. We're going to go to floor, and you're going to see them have a lot of fun. You're going to see them hit their passes and make their leaps all the way around and big smiles on their faces.
All right. Thank you, coach. We appreciate
it. Oh, you're welcome.
the results after the first rotation. Start with vault there, and the top score from Austin Shepherd, probably no surprise. She has been the vaulting specialist here for the Wolverines last year, has worked her way into some of the other events this year, but that is her specialty, and 39825s there for the Wolverines as well here this afternoon. Minnesota on the bars. We showed you a couple of their routines. Lindsay Mabel, again, 9875. So the top gymnasts here in their events come into play here this afternoon. Sierra Thompson with the lowest score there with the 9325 there for Minnesota. But they will take the top five scores on all these different events. The top five of six scores. And there is your beam results. I mentioned the 49.225, the total there for Penn State, the second highest score for them here this season. An impressive showing here out of the gates for the Nittany Lions. And they're on floor. The exuberant and fun routines there from the Iowa Hawkeyes. Mariah Huntley and Angel Metcalf. 9-8 there for the Iowa Hawkeyes. As we'll continue here with the warm-ups here between these four teams. Again, in this second rotation, you'll see Iowa here on the vaults. You see Michigan warming up there on the bars. Minnesota will be on the beam. Penn State there on the floor. And Sean Johnson, is there anyone, I know you're excited to see some routines in the first rotation. Is there anyone who you're looking forward to see here in the second rotation?
If I were to pick out one, I would say Dusty Russell with Minnesota on beam. She might not have the most difficulty, but her artistry and the innovativeness that goes behind her skills, it's a stunning routine to watch and one that really caught my eye.
How would you have described yourself as a beam worker?
I would say I was a little bit of just a powerhouse. I did a lot of skills that people do on floor, on beam, and I just played off of my power.
So keep an eye there on Dusty Russell. She will be in the fourth spot there on beam, there for Minnesota. To lead off there in that event, that'll be Sierra Thompson there for the Gophers. And exuberant fans here in Ann Arbor. Again, this is the first of two quad meets here this afternoon. It can be all gymnastics for you all day long. Quad meet going on here in Ann Arbor. There'll be another quad meet taking place in East Lansing. And the top two finishers from each quad meet will compete in the evening session for next week's Big Ten Championships.
They're getting loud out here.
They are.
Getting excited.
It's a very gymnastics-savvy fan group here in Ann Arbor. A lot of tradition here for the Michigan Wolverines, the 20 Big Ten titles, the 20 NCAA appearances. Here's where we stand here after the first rotation. And you heard Jeff Thompson even say, you know what, we're in first place going into this second rotation. I'm a little bit surprised by that.
I am too. To see a team that starts out on beam to be leading in the first rotation, that's not very common. It's the hardest event you can do, so I'm a little shocked as well, but very impressed.
Jeff Thompson talking to us here before this meet began, and he wanted to stress, it's obviously a very secondary goal, but coming into today, they have a conference best 18 wins. That's the most for Penn State since 2007. Now remember, because this is a quad meet, they are competing against three other teams. They could go 3-0 here and set a new school record by the time this afternoon is done.
And after their first rotation, they're on the right path.
You talked about watching Dusty Russell compete, and we are now just being told that is a late scratch there for her team. We do not know yet who will substitute there in her place, but that's another thing that happens here in gymnastics. Sometimes the coaches watch a warm-up, either they injure themselves or the coaches don't like what they see.
It happens a lot. That's what's hard about gymnastics, is it's all about, you know, it's almost by luck, you know, trying to get through without getting injured. But I actually wondered about that, because in warm-ups, I saw her do a skill and walk off the floor limping, grabbing her hamstring. So I wonder if it is an injury that took her out.
So we're now being told that Justine Sherwink will be in the second spot there for Minnesota. Covers, who was in the second spot, will move down to the third spot. And Rachel Haynes will now officially take the spot there for Dusty Russell. Here we go on the bars here for Michigan. Sachi Sugiyama, the junior.
great connection, a giant fold to a ginger. Gives her extra bonus. Transition down to the low bar. She has great form. You can see her legs are perfectly straight and glued together. Goes to dismount, full twist and double back. One small step.
But a strong way to start that event there for the Wolverines. Sierra Thompson just started her beam routine. We're going to peek in here.
Punch front. Again, front skills are always harder because it's a blind landing. You have to feel your landing instead of actually see it.
You see Thompson's score there on the bars. That was the lowest score, so that did not have to be counted there for Minnesota on that first rotation. The only time she did not compete on the beam, there's a balance check.
Fold it back together. It's always better to balance check than fall off.
She only did not compete on beam one time against Nebraska early February.
Late series. Back hand swing, back layout, step out. Very solid. Just getting ready for a dismount. Punch layout full. Stuck landing. Again, a judge can take that if they want or not.
I was going to say, how long do you have to hold it usually?
You normally have to show that you have control. So if a judge can look at that and say she was in control of her landing, then they'll wave it.
In the leadoff spot here is Allie Glover, a sophomore and one of the all-around competitors here for the Hawkeyes here on foam.
Going in for your Chenko layout full. Small little hop on the landing. Good start.
Update you on a couple of scores. We saw Michigan's Sachi Sugiyama on the bars. She reported a 9.85. Nicole Arts joining her routine a little bit late. Here comes her dismount.
Winding up. Beautiful double layout. Huge height, huge extension, and a stuck landing. Wish I could have seen that whole routine.
Beth Blocky's saying that that's the event that she has been improved on the most. Her score coming in at a 9.9 there for Nicole Arts just moments ago. We go back to the Balsamy Hair here for Iowa.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Touched her hands to the floor. That actually counts as a fall. They can take up to 5/10 for that. She just didn't rotate quite enough.
Well, her score coming in is a 9.075. We head back to the bars, and Shelby Geis, a senior.
Huge release move to Katja. Perfect shoot over to handstand. She shows great control on the bars. Beautiful swing. It's a stuck landing.
Wow.
I think I would give her close to a 10 on that.
Would you really?
I really would.
We'll have to wait on that. Before her, we mentioned Arts with a 9.9, Sachi Sugiyama, the 9.85. And over to Minnesota, who has to do some juggling here on their routines. Justine Sherwin, who was scheduled to be in the exhibition.
Little balance check. It's interesting to see how a team adapts to something that changes so suddenly. Just a dismount, round off. Double twisting layout with a small hop. For an exhibitionist, she did very well under the pressure.
Yeah, a tough spot knowing that as you're warming up, guess what? Suddenly, you're in the lineup.
For a very important meet.
Yes. And a big hug there from Meg Stevenson saying thank you there for stepping up for us. Our State Farm, State of Success, Austin Shepherd, a four-time Big Ten Event Specialist of the Week. Mentioned how she really was a specialist in the vault last season. She has become more well-rounded here this year.
Great bail to handstand. Again, showing great control. Beautiful lines. Double front dismount. very difficult to do. A tiny little step. Only one tenth.
Their scores have been impressive for Michigan. Nicole Arts, the 9-9, a career high. Shelby Geis, the 9-9, ties a career high. I will update you on Austin Shepherd's score. Caroline McCready, now up here on the vaults, here for Iowa.
Yurchenko layout full. Missing a little bit of height there off the vault, but great execution, great form.
McCready reporting the 9-7. Of course, that vault happening moments ago. Joanna Sampson here on the bars.
Bail perfectly the handstand. The judges look for that. They look for them to land in a perfect handstand on the low bar. Hitting all the angles is very important.
She is on the dismount, the double layout.
I'd say Penn State has some huge momentum. So does Michigan.
Solid scores continuing. Austin Shepherd, the 9-8-5. Before Joanna Sampson. Let's bounce over to the floor now. Penn State, of course, coming off that solid beam routine. This is Cassidy Stouter. She's had career best scores in all four events this year. A little bit overshadowed by a couple of the seniors for Penn State that I mentioned, and Madison Merriam, Sharia Musser, who graduated last season.
Layout half, front layout full. Almost went out of bounds there. I think she pulled it in. We'll have to see.
Randy Lowell before her, a 9.825 on the floor. Sydney Sanabria Robles, a 9.775 there on the floor. This is the live routine, picking up on the beginning there of the bar.
Huge release move. She does a ginger. It's probably 5 foot higher than the bar. I don't think I've seen a ginger that high.
I'd love to see you get so excited about these events.
Just a discount. Again, huge high.
Wow.
She's a powerhouse, man.
Natalie Bielstein. And we'll see her on the floor routine here later this afternoon. But a powerful performance for the Wolverines there on bars.
Going in for your Yurchenko layout half. Stuck landing. They might be able to take a little deduction for her form in the layout. You can see her legs weren't quite together.
Heading over to Rachel Haynes from Minnesota, who just got on the beam here for the Gophers. She was moved down to the fourth spot, originally slotted there in the third spot, one of the freshmen here for Minnesota.
I'll add on beam, it's always difficult to have so much excitement going on around you and trying to stay calm, because over excitement and adrenaline really throws off your balance.
A lot of these competitors used to dual competitions here throughout the regular season, although they do compete in some quad meets throughout as well. But you're right, beam is not necessarily one thing that there's going to be a lot of cheering for.
Great dismount, gainer layout full, stuck landing. She showed great control in her routine.
The beam set up right next to the bars and the floor, kind of sandwiched in between those two events that obviously can get a lot of reaction from the crowds as well. We head back over to the vault, Angel Metcalf. See her score the 9-8 on the floor there in the first rotation.
Coming back from her shin injury, the vault will put the most stress and pressure on them. Yurchenko layout full with a huge height off the vault, small step on the landing.
It's the eighth time that she is competing in the all-around here this season. Lindsay Mabel, this is the conversation you were talking about, a last-minute conversation there with the coach in the 2013 championships, tied for first as a freshman, by the way.
Very strong on this event. Her connections are more difficult than a lot of the competitors here. She's had some balance checks and falls here this season, but been working hard to come back in. Saves that. Again, you can see a little hesitation in the air, but fixes it on her landing.
Rachel Haynes recording before her a season high 9-9. So Minnesota, again, had to do some juggling. Took Dusty Russell out of its lineup, had to juggle some other people in. So far, the lowest score for the Gophers on this event at 9.675.
So far, so good. Very solid. Not giving the judges anything. Just her dismount. Aerial to layout fall. Huge bonus there. And stuck landing.
Competed in the all-around in every meet. That'll be a big score there for Lindsay Mabel. We'll update it.
Double pike opening with a stuck landing.
Lindsay Musgrove, a senior here for Penn State. She won floor last weekend.
Floor is always the event where the girls can just kind of let go and breathe and have fun. You can't fall off the floor too easily, so lets them enjoy it a little bit more.
Again, so impressed going into this floor routine, what Penn State was able to do on the beam. Jeff Thompson said it's one of their best events, but being one of your best events and then starting out on it and performing are two different things.
Getting our jump series in.
Your final pass here coming up for Lindsay Musgrove.
Going for a double back. Stuck landing shows great control. By the time you get to the end of your floor routine, you're always tired, so it's interesting to see the ones who end with a very difficult pass.
Her score coming in a tying a season high with a 9.925 there for Lindsay Musgrove. Jordan Doherty, a freshman there for Iowa, as we head back over to the vault just moments ago.
Amping herself up. Yurchenko, layout full. Great height and form. Just the hop on the landing that the judge can take.
In the anchor spot, as we head back over to the beam, you see Kylie Sherman starting off her routine. Lindsay Mabel, her teammate, recording a season high, tying for a season high of a 9.925 just before her. We saw that strong routine right before Sherman.
Well earned. I would have given her the same. Light series, handspring layout. Doesn't have too much height with it, but lands it very solid.
Meg Stevenson says, look for her dismount. It's a big one here coming up.
Switch leap, straddle three quarters. Again, landing sideways instead of straight on. It's funny, that little full turn you see, it's probably one of the hardest skills a girl can do on the beam. It's so easy, it's really difficult, if that makes sense.
It looks innocent.
It does. But
it can be vicious, huh?
Very vicious. Here's her dismount. Round off, double back. You don't see that in collegiate gymnastics very often, but executed it very well with just a tiny step.
Her coach said, keep an eye on it. She performed well. She's already performed her first pass here on the floor. This is Crystal Welsh as we pick it up for her second pass coming up.
Punch front step out. Two and a half twisting layout. Racking up the bonus points there.
Welsh was limited with injury last year, but she has competed in the all-around in 10 meets this season, make it 11 here today.
She must have come back from her injury pretty strong then. What you don't realize is if these all-arounders are competing 11 times, that's back-to-back every week, and it can get very exhausting.
All four events, week to week to week. Take a pound in there on the body. Her final pass here coming up.
A huge double pike. Showing great control on the landing as well. Really feeding off of the momentum they got on the beam.
An impressive showing there for the Nittany Lions, who, if they finish in first place, could actually win a share of the regular season Big Ten title. Penn State is in that boat. Minnesota is also in that boat. Two rotations down, Jeff Thompson has to be happy with his performance from his team here so far. We'll give you the update so far as we reach the midway point with the third rotation coming up. While watching Big Ten sports, add to the action with BTN Connect. See all the Twitter activity from around the conference, get in-game stats, and interact with our experts. Join your favorite team with btn.com/connect and get socially charged. After two rotations are down, we are at the halfway point. And Iowa head coach Larissa Libby joining us now. And coach, we have talked about the situation that you and your team are in. 11 competing, six of those walk-ons. Two rotations down, two to go. Evaluate how this young and inexperienced team has done so far for you.
I think they've got more to give. Certainly, it's challenging, and there's no question. Six walk-ons, you know, we don't have a lot of depth, but they've gone through the year like that, so it's not anything new. I think they're a little cautious right now, so I'm hoping that they'll pick it up in the back two events. Bars and beam left, although those are harder events, I think, for us right now. We need more stuck landings, casting to handstand, just all of those little details are the things that we need to pick it up on right now.
So, coach, knowing that the two harder events are left and the girls know they have to hit, what's the mentality? What are you telling them?
Focus on the here and the now. It's the same message that we've given them all year. You can't really think about what we just did or what's coming up. They've got to stay in that moment and focus on every single detail that they can in that moment. We can't control anything that happens outside of that. We can only control our enthusiasm, our environment, and essentially what we do in that moment. So that's the message. And we're not talking about winning. We're not talking about Big Tens. We're not talking about any of that. Just the event that we're on in that moment.
I'm motivated after listening to you. I hope your team is.
Suit up, Lisa. We can use you.
Thank you for the time.
Thank you.
Happy to have you with us here in Ann Arbor. Again, we mentioned it's the halfway point alongside the four-time Olympic medalist, Sean Johnson. I'm Lisa Byington. This is your first year as an analyst for us, your first time seeing really kind of a quad meet. And this is a first here for the Big Ten Conference to set it up the last weekend of the regular season to have two quad competitions. What are your initial impressions here so far?
I would just say the team camaraderie, the spirit is unbelievable. Coming from a soloist, where I only had to focus on me. I love how much they work together, the spirit, everything, but also the difficulty. I'm seeing elite level gymnastics here, and it's very impressive.
Here's where we stand. You know, Penn State was in the lead after the first rotation, but the Michigan Wolverines would maybe the most to compete for here today. A win would give them the outright Big Ten regular season championship. They have now jumped into the lead after two rotations, after very strong showings here on the bars, a couple of career highs from Nicole Arts there and Shelby Geis. And we start out with the results there on vault there for Iowa. Now this is, so look back here with the second rotation there for Iowa and Michigan on the bars. Here's what they did. I mentioned the couple of career highs and then the 9.95 led by Joanna Sampson. Here's a little bit of a look in her bar routine.
Huge scores. Michigan really gaining momentum. Sampson is just a powerhouse with her height and execution.
Just a solid routine there from Joanna Sampson. We wouldn't expect anything less from the all-arounder and one of the best gymnasts that has ever come through the Michigan program. Lindsay Mabel at 9.925 as a sophomore, having an incredible career already. And here is a look at her beam routine, just a few moments of it.
And that's a huge jump from their last competition where she scored a 9.3 on the beam. So has to help her confidence a lot.
Jeff Thompson and the Nittany Lions on the floor there in the second rotation. Here's their results, the couple of 9.85s from Lindsay Musgrove and Crystal Welsh. And here is Welsh. Here's a look at her routine on the floor. Your all-around competition. Mabel in first, Sampson in second. We will continue to keep an eye on that. We showed you a couple of their routines as well. So we start with our third rotation here, and we start with Nicole Arts here on the beam. That 9.9, a career high that you saw there from the bars in the second rotation.
She has beautiful lines. Shows a lot of confidence on the beam, just rock solid. That little full turn I was telling you about.
Arts has been in the leadoff spot for Michigan all season long.
Small balance check, saved it. Just her dismount left. Front hand turns out left, stuck landing. Great way to start off that event. I can see why she has the starting position so much.
Getting Michigan off on the right foot there on that event. Heading back over to Allie Glover for Iowa, a sophomore there on the bars.
Giant pull, little leg separation there, form break. Great connection into the release. Just her dismount left. Double layout, small hop. If I were to take anything, it would just be the leg separation throughout the routine.
How much would you take off for that?
A judge can take anywhere from a tenth to three every time they see it.
Again, all very subjective. As we head over to Lindsay Musgrove. Now, this was moments ago here on the vault for Penn State.
Going in for the Urchenko layout half. Just the hop on the landing. I think you see with collegiate gymnastics, it all comes down to the landing. They've got great form and execution. Whoever sticks it, though, comes out on top.
Judges giving Musgrove a 9.8. Again, that vault happening just moments ago. We're going to hop around all four events taking place at once. We will join some routines in progress, as we will do with Justine Sherwink's floor routine here.
Front handspring layout 1.5.
Sherwink inserted into the beam lineup last minute, but she was planning on being the leadoff spot here for Minnesota on floor.
Something with the floor routine is judges go in giving them requirements. So when they're choreographing this routine, there's a point in the routine they have to sit on the floor, they have to add certain dance elements, and that's how they kind of put it together.
Sherwink wrapping up her routine to lead off that event there for the Gophers. We head back to the bars. Jordan Doherty in the second spot here for Iowa. Allie Glover, her teammate, reporting the 9.75 just before her.
Starting out with a giant full to a shoot over. Little form break there, but still hit the handstand. Winding it for a dismount. Huge double layout, stuck landing. Looks pretty happy with that one.
A great reaction there from Jordan Doherty. Loved it. And then back over to Penn State just moments ago here on the vaults. Crystal Welsh, the junior.
Yurchenko half on front pipe. It's actually a harder vault than you've seen everybody else do because she turns before actually hitting the vault.
That one happening moments ago. She recorded a 9.825 on that score. This is now live on the beam.
Fall on Michigan.
This is Shelby Geis in the third spot here for Michigan. Just Alia Shirelli before her recording the 9.825 and the 9.9 for Nicole Arts. So some solid scores up to this point.
Second fall. This is where you see, you know, when you fall during your routine, it kind of, it breaks your confidence, it breaks your rhythm, and you know, you can either get back and kind of reset yourself or be kind of flustered by it. And seen two falls so far.
We saw her fall in her warm-up session as well. And so how much does that maybe, when you fall in the warm-up, how does that mentally play when you need to have a count?
You know, you kind of always have that in the back of your mind. Am I going to do this again or not? And it can really throw you off and affect you. So
Shelby Geis, that is most likely a score that Michigan will not want to count. Again, they have the 9.825 and the 9.9 here before Geis's routine. Randy Lau moments ago on the vault.
Very powerful. Yurchenko layout fall, stuck landing. Another solid score.
It's been solid here between Penn State and Michigan. Something to keep an eye on. Again, Michigan finishing first here today would win the outright Big Ten championship, going 3-0 against the other three teams. Penn State, if the Nittany Lions were to finish first, they could get a share of the regular season championship. Back to Austin Shepherd here on the beam.
You see a lot with athletes before they go up to compete. They do a lot of visualizing, trying to envision what their routine is going to do, how they're going to execute it.
Oh!
Fall right off the start. One of the hardest mounts you can do on beam.
One of the risk rewards of a difficult mount. Yeah, Shelby Geis recording the 8.475 before Austin Shepherd. So this puts pressure.
Oh,
now
no.
Two falls here from Michigan on this event.
Again, it all comes down to that rhythm. You gain a momentum, and when you break it, you kind of have to reset yourself before getting back on.
Last week, the Wolverines fell, but in the first spot, and that was Nicole Arts, and she rebounded it from that nicely. She got the career-high 9.9 to lead off in this event. Michigan.
Just a small step. I would say outside of the falls, she has beautiful form and capabilities on beam.
So the Wolverines in a bit of a tight spot here as they have Joanna Sampson and Lindsay Williams perhaps, or maybe Rima Zachariah we'll see there to finish off the beam. Cassidy Stouter, moments ago here on the vault for Penn State.
Step there on the landing. Don't know if a judge would take that, but like we keep saying, it's subjective.
You know, Stouter's kind of a funny story on the vaults. Jeff Thompson is telling me earlier this week that they thought it was nearly impossible to put Cassidy Stouter in the vault lineup. She couldn't even do a basket Yurchenko vault lineup, and now you see her and she's performing very, very strong. The 9.725 there on that vault that had it moments ago. Here back on the bars, and you see the dismount.
Huge dismount. Full extension, double layout with a stuck landing.
Angel Metcalf. one of the all-arounders. And we'll head over live here to Joanna Sampson. A ton of pressure here to get a big score on beam. Austin Shepherd before her, an 8.625. Remember, Shelby Geis with the 8.475.
First flight series by Cancer and Layout Step Up. It's her first test of the pressure. See if it affects her. Seems pretty unaffected right now. You can always tell a seasoned competitor when they're able to put that behind them and still compete. Jump series.
The sixth best all-around average here in the country.
Side aerial to a split jump. Great connection. She'll get that bonus. Just her dismount. Round out double twisting layout with a stuck landing.
And boy, did Michigan need that. It'll be a high score and a strong performance from their top gymnast coming through. Back over to the bars here for IOI on the dismount.
Another huge full extension double layout with a stuck landing. They're really hitting their landings on bars.
Angel Metcalf recording a 9.85. That is a season high there for Iowa. They're on the bars. We head over to take a look at the freshman moments ago on the vault. Emma Simpson. Last week, an outstanding performance on vault, a 9.975. So close to a 10.
Front handspring, front pike half. Huge height off the vault with great form. Only thing they can take is that landing.
So Lindsay Williams here competing in the anchor spot here for Michigan. Now Briley Casanova was scratched going into today. Sprained her ankle on Wednesday.
Need a big score here for them.
Race series. Joanna Sampson getting a 9.9.
Well deserved.
He said, look for her graceful big jumps.
Huge flight series by Canspring Layout Step Out. Another one of those athletes on the beam where her artistry, her lines, it's exactly what a judge wants to see, what they look for.
Came down to Lindsay Williams and Rena Zachariah here to compete in this anchor spot. There's the dismount.
Gainer Pike. I would say they can take a tenth or two on that landing.
But important for Michigan. They did not have to report a fall in the final two routines. Going back to vault moments ago, Penn State, Sydney, Sanabria Robles.
Your Chenko layout full, just the little hop on the landing. Great extension, great form.
The little hop giving her a 9.8 score. And that vault happening moments ago. But the freshman and Emma Simpson recording a 9.825. That was the top score, along with Crystal Welsh. They're on vault for Penn State. So the Nittany Lions, five more strong scores here that they can count there on that vault event. Interesting to see, after this third rotation is complete, where Michigan here will stand coming into the lead after the first two rotations. We head back to bars. Mariah Huntley.
Former teammate of mine, grew up with her since we were four. Great release move.
She added bars.
She did. Last time we saw her, she was exhibitioning. So this is a step up for her. Just her dismount.
It's going to be a big one.
Double layout. Just a step on the landing.
Iowa, we talk about their inexperience. And their coach, we heard from her, Larissa Libby, saying, hey, it is something that we have had to deal with all season long. Sierra Thompson here for Minnesota on the floor. The beginning of her routine.
Powerful music. Really getting the audience in. First pass here. Double pike. Great form and control on the landing.
Last week, Minnesota tied for the fifth best score in floor in program history with a 49.45. Looking to build on that momentum here in this championship quad meet.
She has left is her last pass. Two and a half twisting layout. Just a small step on the landing. I'd say it's going to be a pretty big score.
Sierra Thompson, 39.2 last week, finished second in the all-around competition. The storyline to watch here in this third rotation, Michigan coming in with the lead. We go back to Talia Shirelli, one of the freshmen here. This was her routine here in the second spot for B. We're going back to show it to you. Tell you how Michigan here has been able to put up at least four solid scores. Lindsay Williams coming in with tying a career high with a 9.825. They're in that anchor spot. Looking at Shirelli and her dismount.
Dismount, another huge double back. They can take a couple tenths on that landing, but great form.
So she recorded the 9.825 in that spot. Going back to Lindsay Mabel in the anchor spot there on the floor from Minnesota.
Ranked fifth in the country on floor. This is her best event.
Last week she had a 9.925.
Sounds pretty good.
And she tied for third with a 9.925, if you can believe it.
Huge powerhouse, double pike, perfectly controlled landing.
Finished fourth in the floor in the NCAA's last year.
You can tell at this event, she just has fun. She really enjoys it. Second pass, punch layout, 1.5, straddle jump, front tuck. Very interesting connection, but shows, again, great control on it. Judge can't take anything away.
Why do you use the word interesting?
Because you see most girls go for like the front handspring, front layout, and she kind of mixes it up, adds a dance element, a front tuck. She gets a lot of bonus for it.
Here she is with her final pass.
Layout, 1.5, front layout. Possibly beating her 9.925.
That's what she got last week. The sophomore, another strong showing. Hard to believe she has only been competing at the collegiate level two full seasons.
She shows the control of a senior.
And a hug there from the head coach. That'll be a big score there for Lindsay Mabel. Sierra Thompson before her, a 9.85. We showed her you some of her routine. We'll take a look here at the final pass here for Lindsay Mabel.
Going in for a layout, 1.5 front layout. She just shows such control over such difficult elements.
Lindsay Mabel, the super soft, will be heading to the vault next to wrap things up. It's been fun here so far through the first three rotations. A championship to be had when we come back. Mike, thanks a lot. We look forward to watching that there from East Lansing. First, we got to wrap things up in our quad meet here in Ann Arbor. Three rotations are now down. We head into that fourth and final rotation, and joining us now is Minnesota head coach Meg Stevenson, who, if you finish in first place, coach, as you know, you can win a share of the Big Ten title. What is your message here after three rotations for your team?
Three down, one to go. And that's all we're thinking about is we've got one rotation left. We're focusing on that, and we're in the moment and in the present, and that's what's been working for us tonight, so we're going to do that for our last event as well.
And, Coach, you've shown great consistency on the three events. Vault, you know, the girls can kind of take the pressure off themselves. What are they excited about? What can we look forward to seeing?
Well, the thing that's so nice about vault is you can just let it rip. And so I think that's kind of a nice event to finish on, because run hard, work hard, and you can't hold back. So it's kind of fun to be ending on that event.
Coach, we appreciate the time. Thank you.
Thank you.
They recorded a 49.2 as a team there on floor today, their season high of 49.45. So after three rotations, look at this. We have a new leader. We've had a new leader after every rotation. Penn State after the first, Michigan after the second, and now Minnesota here in the lead. 147.5 there for the Gophers. As we mentioned, for Minnesota and Penn State, they have to finish in first to win at least a share of the regular season title. A gymnast kind of knows about championships and winning titles. How about in 2013, Katie Zorales? They're on the vaults. A Big Ten champion there on the vaults. And what is she doing now? Katie Zorales, present day, helping me out with stats and trying to make me look awfully smart. Who's going to attend med school? I know you don't have a microphone on you. You can just nod your head back and forth. Yes. Thank you for your help. A seven-time NCAA All-American. And making us sound all smart all day long with all those stats. Here is your vault results. Crystal Welsh and Emma Simpson with the high scores there as a 9.825. We'll take a look here at Crystal Welsh's vault. Head over to the bars. This is what Iowa did in the third rotation. Angel Metcalf tied for the lead there with Sydney Hare, a 9.85. And here is Angel competing in the all-around here today.
With that huge double layout.
Stuck the landing. Team loves it. Heading over to Michigan, and that was the storyline there of the third rotation. Two falls you see there with Shepard and Geis. And so this is Nicole Arts, a career-high 9.9 here for the freshman. And this was her dismount.
Really bringing in the anchor position.
And the Gophers on floor. This is how they took the lead going into the fourth and final rotation. You see Lindsay Mabel, the sophomore, had a 9.9 performance there in the anchor spot. Take another look here at Mabel's routine there on the floor.
Going into the last rotation, they do have an advantage of being on vaults and not one of the more difficult events like bars or beam.
We've talked about it. We want to remind you about it. Coming up next, the other four teams from East Lansing, Illinois, Michigan State, Nebraska, and Ohio State in a quad meet to determine the other seedings for next week's championships. Coverage begins right after we're done here in Ann Arbor. Remember, the championships taking place next week in State College at Penn State. We will again have an afternoon session and an evening session, as we noted at the beginning. It is possible to win a Big Ten championship next week if you're in the afternoon. Not very likely, though, with the scores that are handed out in that afternoon session. The teams here wrapping up their warm-up session as we head down to the floor in maybe Michigan's top event. They got to have top performances to retake the lead and win that outright title. Sachi Sugiyama to lead things off.
First pass here. Going for a huge double back. Interesting about her, the leotards you see them wearing as a team today, she actually designed.
An art and design major? And a pretty good one. You can get the okay from your peers and your teammates, right?
Oh, yeah.
She's competed in three events all year long.
Floor is always the best event to end on. Kind of like Minnesota coach is saying, you get to just let loose here as well. All the pressure's off.
The height.
Great artistry. Dance element. Just the last pass. Huge double pike. A little under rotated. She got a little excited, opened up.
Is that normally an error that happens when the adrenaline's building?
Actually, very frequent. You just get too excited, you kind of lose yourself and want to finish a little earlier than you should.
One floor routine down there for Michigan, five more to come. And the roar you're hearing is from some of the vault performances here from Minnesota. We'll go back and try to show you as many as we can. Witten here for Penn State in the second bar routine here for the Nittany Lions.
Starting right off with the release move connection. Giant half to huge pike Jaeger. Straight to her overshoot connection. Really racking up the bonus points there.
Those are dismount.
Stretch dad double layout. Small hop on the landing. Judge can probably take a 10th. But very clean routine.
Nice job. Going back to Brooke Parker for Michigan on the floor. Sachi Sugiyama's score coming in as a 9.725.
Round off double Arabian. Again, not something you see very often in collegiate gymnastics. Huge, powerful pass.
Makes you smile ear to ear.
It really does. Front pike step out. Double back.
Oh.
Out of bounds.
Which will be what? A deduction?
It'll be up to 5 tenths just for the fall, and then they can take about 5 more for the steps out of bounds.
A transfer from Alabama. We'll have 1 year left to compete here for Michigan. Pass here coming up.
Going for a round off double pike. Great landing. They do get to drop one score, so hopefully from here on out they hit everything.
Puts a little bit of pressure on the final four gymnasts there on floor here from Michigan. Over to the vault. Minnesota with the lead going into the fourth and final rotation. Here is Rachel Haynes moments ago in the leadoff spot.
Yurchenko layout full. Tiny little hop on the landing. Great height off the vault though and perfect form.
Recording a 9.775 there on that vault performance. Heading over to take a look at Randy Lau there for Penn State, former USA national team member.
Actually got to compete with her a few times. Starting off giant half to release, Jaeger, great height. And a fall. Didn't quite make it to a low bar.
We'll go back and check on her. We'll head back to the floor here from Michigan. Natalie Bielstein here. Always a powerful and fun routine to watch. Rick Parker reporting a 9.15 before her.
Full twisting double back. Just a ball of energy. Kind of like bars, she just goes sky high on everything.
Doesn't hold back. She had a 9.95 last weekend. Been an All-American on floor, second team in 2011, first team in 2010.
Just her last pass. Again, feeling the pressure from her previous teammate, knowing she has to stick it. Her handspring, double twisting layout, front layout. Very strong routine.
Natalie Bielstein, solid. We'll go back here to check in on Randy Laus. Wrapping up the routine after that fall there on bars.
Always hard to have a disconnection. You kind of get stumbled up a little bit. Double back a little short. Just a small hop on the landing.
Sarah Thompson back to the vault in the second spot moments ago here from Minnesota.
Handspring, front pike half, stuck landing. Team seems pretty happy about that. It'd be a high score.
It was indeed a 9.8 coming in there for Sierra Thompson. So a 9.775 for Haynes, a 9.8 for the first two vaults there from Minnesota. Let's check in here on Boone.
That handspring layout step out. Little low, little form break, but solid landing.
Allie Glover, just a sophomore. Competing all around in the last seven meets.
Now, from experience, I will say, beam is never fun to end on.
Not fun to start on, not fun to end on, not fun to be in the second or third row. It's just not
fun.
Yeah,
true. Yeah. In our loop series, switch loops, travel jump. Just her dismount. Front layout full, stuck landing.
Going back to Nicole Arts Live. Pick it up after her first pass here on floor. Natalie Bielstein, her teammate, a 9.875, the routine that we saw just before her.
Layout full. Great form and execution. Huge double pipe. Team seems really excited about that.
They needed a big performance there from the freshman. She came through there for the Wolverines, her team appreciated that. Moments ago here, we continue to peek in on the vault. Jenny Covers, the junior from Minnesota.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Huge height off the vault. I'd say one of the stronger layout falls we've seen tonight.
It's the top score for Minnesota so far on this event, a 9.85 there for Jenny Covers, following the 9.8 there from Sierra Thompson. Moments ago, over to Penn State there on the bars, Crystal Welsh.
Overshoot to handstand. Double front half, stuck landing. So excited over that again.
Yes, moments ago, that was a season high. Crystal Welsh recording the 9.875. We're going to peek in live now to Rima Zachariah in her floor routine.
Running double front, one of the harder passes we'll see tonight as well.
One of the captains, one of the seniors here from Michigan.
Great flexibility. I feel like you can tell that the teams are getting really excited, getting close to the end. Little balance check there on the landing.
See her team dancing with her. Always my favorite thing to watch in the floor routines.
Just her last pass. Ground off, double fight, huge height.
Love the way she ends that routine.
I think they're gaining their momentum back.
Well, they need four straight solid performances, and so far they've gotten three with Joanna Sampson on deck there from Michigan. We head back to the bars. And Penn State wrapping up its routine. Starting out there on the high bar.
Straight into a release move. Giant fall to Takachev. Great height. Perfect handstand. Showing great form as well. Legs are glued. Double layout, stuck landing. I'd say that should be a very high score.
A 9-9, that score coming in, that routine just finishing up moments ago. A strong way for Penn State to end that event. Kayla Schlechta in the fourth spot here for Minnesota on vault. Interesting way to start.
Going in for another Yurchenko layout full. Just a step on the landing. Gets great height off the vault.
That was moments ago, and she recorded a 9-8 on that event. Looked like almost like a track sprinter the way she was going to start that routine.
Starting out of the blocks.
Joanna Sampson is your defending NCAA floor champ. As we see her, she's about ready to begin her routine. So fundamentally sound. Loves pressure-packed situations, and here's another one here for the senior. Michigan needs a big score from her in the anchor spot. You talked about it at the beginning. You're going to watch this quad. This is one of the reasons you should stick till the end.
It really is. She's a powerhouse. Experienced competitor, senior, former. Okay, we're starting out with a double layout here. Had dinner myself. That's huge. That's something you see, again, in Olympic-level gymnastics, and we're seeing it tonight.
That's her traditional way of starting out this routine. 17 all-around titles, 47 individual events in her career.
Front layout, full front layout. Interleague series in, showing great flexibility as well. That's what a judge wants. They want the power and the tumbling, and they want the flexibility and the artistry. And she's got it both.
Something tells me she would almost like to be in this position where her routine absolutely means something for her team.
I would say so. When you've got a competitor, that experience, they feed off of that adrenaline and that pressure. Last pass, huge double fight. Stuck landing. Wow. Very interesting way to finish.
Joanna Sampson, but will it be enough? Michigan trailing Minnesota going into the fourth rotation. We'll take another look here at her final pass.
A huge double pike. She tumbles with a vengeance and sticks the landing every time.
Michigan going up against directly Minnesota on the vault. Moments ago, Kylie Sherman here on the vault. Saw her on beam in the junior in the fifth spot here in the rotation for the Gophers.
Another Yurchenko full stop landing. This should be another huge score.
They're going to be tough to beat. They have hit all of their vault routines so far. Some future gymnasts taking this in. They always draw well here in Ann Arbor, but wondering if the home team is good enough here in the final rotation to beat out Minnesota here on the vault. The sixth spot, the anchor spot, Lindsay Mabel.
Also nationally ranked on vault. Take a layout, most tech landing. I don't know if you can take anything away from that one.
13th in the country, averages a 9.915 in this event. Tied for fifth in the NCAA's last year. We're gonna sort things out and tally up the final scores. Could we crown a regular season champion here in the Ann Arbor quad? We'll let you know when we come back. Want to remind you that coming up next, it's the other four teams from East Lansing, Illinois, Michigan State, Nebraska, and Ohio State in a quad meet to determine the other seedings for next week's championships. Coverage begins right after we're done here in Ann Arbor. But what an exciting afternoon it has been here at the Chrysler Center. Minnesota, Penn State, Iowa, and Michigan all competing, one for at least a share of the Big Ten championship. Michigan, of course, finishing first, could have won an outright regular season Big Ten championship. Penn State and Minnesota had a chance to get at least a share. Here are your results after the fourth and final rotation. Minnesota Golden Gophers had the lead going into this rotation. They need a solid vault performance. They got it, led by the sophomore there in Lindsay Mabel with her 9.9. Here's another look at it.
Huge vault. I don't think a judge can take much from that.
She got the 9.9 there, and here are the bar results. You see Jeff Thompson chatting with Ben Plocky, and the Nittany Lions led after the first rotation. This is what they did after the fourth rotation. Cassidy Stouter, a 9.9 on the bars. Let's take another look.
They showed such control on the bars, sticking almost every landing, hitting every handstand.
Cassidy Stouter in that anchor spot there for Penn State. And for Iowa, and Larissa Libby, who has the six walk-ons. Molly Drenth, Allie Glover, a couple of 9.8s there on the beam, and a career high there for Molly Drenth and her 9.8.
Good dismount here. Round off layout, 1.5. Showing great form.
And Michigan's floor results needed some big performances. They got it in the anchor spot there from Joanna Sampson with the top score of the 9.925. We'll take a look at her first pass in that floor routine, the one that you love with the double layout. Oh, that's not Sampson. Apologies for that. It was so good that we couldn't show it to you twice. It would have knocked you out. We'll try and get that to you. But Joanna Sampson, in that anchor spot for a reason, came up with the top score there for Michigan. And the Wolverines were trailing Minnesota going into that fourth and final rotation. We'll go back and look here at Joanna Sampson. It's worth a look. She's the defending NCAA champ here on this event.
Last pass being our huge double pike. The unique way she ends it.
I was going to say, you love the way that she ends that routine. So we're tallying the results. Your team results look like this. Minnesota, first place after today, meaning they can win a share of the Big Ten championship. They can do that with Nebraska competing in the quad in East Lansing. We'll have to wait to see if the Gophers can win a share with the Huskers. And you see Penn State finishing in second. So you have Minnesota and Penn State locking up those two evening sessions, and Michigan and Iowa will now have to compete in the afternoon session next week. You're all around competition. How about that? Lindsay Mabel, Joanna Sampson, the two gymnasts that you focused on. It's like you know what you're talking about.
I really did. I said you can't find two girls who are more evenly matched. And, I mean, they have almost identical career high scores, everything. And
you were
they
going
tied.
Through, I mean, you were going through all their statistics, all their scores all season long, and you kept saying, Lisa, they're so equal. They're so even. And when they went head-to-head today, it proved to be exactly that. You look at Joanna Sampson. Finishing in a tie for first. There you see the scores again, a 39.6 between Mabel and Sampson. Arguably the two best all-arounders here you see today. Of course, all kinds of all-around action and team competition still to go underway in East Lansing. But we will sort things out and wrap things up here from Ann Arbor, Minnesota, finishing first here at the Chrysler Center. Those are your results there, your team results. Minnesota finishing in first, Penn State in second. Should mention, too, that that gives Penn State now 20 wins on the year. That's the most in Nittany Lion history. But Minnesota now guaranteeing itself a share of the Big Ten title. And joining us now is head coach Meg Stevenson. First of all, congratulations. I want to know if you held true. You told me. I don't do scoreboard watching. I'm going to have associate head coach Jenny Hansen do that for me. When you were in the lead going into the final rotation, how much did you know that you were in the lead?
I didn't know we were in the lead. In fact, I didn't see any of the beam scores, so I really had no idea where we were. But I knew we were doing well just by the performances of the women on the team, so I was feeling pretty good.
Again, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now going into next week, how does this set you up? How are you guys going to train and prepare? What are you thinking?
Well, we only have 2 days before we leave to head to Penn State, so we'll be smart, and we'll back off just a little on that first day, and then the second day try to build back up and be ready to travel. But certainly we'll have a boost of adrenaline after the win tonight.
What kind of performance did you expect from your team going into today? Sometimes coaches get a feel for their team. What was your feel going into this weekend?
You know, I trust them. I really believe in them. And they love to compete, so it's been a really fun team to work with just because they know what they want to do, and they go after it. So it's been fun just to be able to guide that and be a part of it.
All right, Coach, thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Go, go.
Minnesota now guaranteeing itself a share of the title. Now the question is, will the Gophers share it with Nebraska? That question will be answered, of course, in the East Lansing quad. But we will wrap things up here from the Ann Arbor quad when we come back. Some of the questions have now been answered after our quad meet here in Ann Arbor. In the afternoon session, we now know it'll be the Wolverines and the Hawkeyes, and the Gophers and the Nittany Lions earning a place in that 5 p.m. evening session there in Penn State, which will be live. Both of those sessions, the 12 o'clock and 5 o'clock, will be live next week on BTN. You can see the other teams competing in the East Lansing quad there. And Nebraska in the lead, the Huskers in the lead to maybe get a share of the title there with the Minnesota Golden Gophers. But this is the first time this Big Ten Conference has ever tried something like this with two different quads here to end the regular season. What was your biggest takeaway, Sean Johnson, out of today?
I would say the teams just brought their best energy, their best competitive drive, huge execution, huge difficulty. And, you know, I'm excited to see next weekend. It's going to be a lot of great competitions and great competitors.
And an exciting weekend, too, for Penn State that will be able to compete on its home turf, whatever you want to call it. And they will be in the evening session after finishing here in second place. It was exciting. I mean, we had three different leaders after the first three rotations. Minnesota really competed hard, competed tough in that fourth and final rotation on the vault and came home. And you see there the final scores, 196.7 to win at least a share. We'll have to see if Nebraska can finish first in the East Lansing quad, then those two will tie for a share. If not, Minnesota will win the outright title.
It'll be an interesting competition to see, but Minnesota sure brought it today.
Again, we want to remind you, we will air those championships next weekend live on BTN from State College. For now, that'll do it for Michigan. Minnesota finishing in first, Penn State second, Michigan third, and Iowa fourth. The all-around winners, Lindsay Mabel of Minnesota, Joanna Sampson of Michigan. Remember, the Big Ten championships next weekend on BTN. Coming up next, the other four Big Ten teams from East Lansing.